Hey guys, I'm Pokemon106 and welcome back to a special video. Today's video is going to be my first legit video game review, and that game I'm going to be talking about is Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu for the Nintendo Switch. When I first heard the news about a Pokemon game coming to the Switch, just like everybody else, I damn near shit my pants in excitement. Especially considering the fact that it's like basically one of the games that are like the 3DS, and then when I found that it was a remake of Yellow, I was like, that's really cool because I only got the experience of playing Yellow only for a little bit. I didn't have really much of a Game Boy Pokemon games like my friends did, so I usually would play their copies. That's how I usually got to experience them. So when I found out that it was a remake of Yellow, it was cool. As much as I liked Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, I have to say that there are some pros and then there are some cons that came with the game. So without further ado, let's get started. Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee are 2018 remakes of a 1998 role-playing Pokemon video game, Pokemon Yellow. They were developed by Game Freak, published by the Pokemon Company and Nintendo for the Nintendo Switch. Announced back in May 2018, Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee were released worldwide for the Nintendo Switch on November 16, 2018. Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Pokemon Let's Go Eevee were first announced at the Japan press conference back in May 2018, with the intention for the games to bring in newcomers to the series as well as cater to the old fans alike. They were also meant to attract a younger audience since the games incorporate elements from the anime. They received general favorite reviews from critics. The games combined worldwide have a sales of over 11.76 million as of December 2019. Surely it has increased by now, making them one of the best-selling games for the system. They feature connectivity with the mobile game Pokemon Go and support an additional controller, the Pokeball Plus. For those of you that didn't want the optional controller, you can buy the game for a cheaper price.
So I'm going to go ahead and start with the pros of Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee. So for starters, when I first played, I played both of them. I own Let's Go Pikachu and I got Let's Go Eevee for my job. Both games, same thing, except when you get a starter, your starter Pokemon, and one, of course, is Pikachu, and then the other, it's Eevee. Both games, like I said, let's start with the pros. It definitely was just like Yellow from what I could remember. You know, you start off basically as a young trainer, and in Palutown, and then you go off to various cities, battle the 8 gym leaders, and then you battle the Elite Four, and then the champion. The pros I liked about it was that it's a Pokemon game on the Switch. The animation was really good. I know some people were like, oh, it kind of like buffered a little bit. Yeah, there was a bit of buffering, but not as much as in, I want to say, Sword and Shield. Sword and Shield had a bit more buffering when it came to playing, but it was still pretty good. There are more cons, actually, when I think about it, with more than pros. What I didn't like about the game was the fact that it only had Gen 1 Pokemon and Alolan Pokemon. And by that, I mean if you were to go to, I think it's Fuchsia City, you can access the Pokemon Go Park, where it allows you to link up with your Pokemon Go account, and you can download Pokemon that you caught from Pokemon Go into the game, and you can catch them at the park. Like I said, that's how you were able to really get access to Alolan Pokemon, because they weren't going to show up in the game unless you were to have catch some in Pokemon Go, and then you were to bring them over like that. But all you really get is Gen 1 Pokemon. In a way, I mean, yeah, so when you're playing Yellow only had, Gen 1 Pokemon. Some people were a little disappointed with that. I was one of them, because it's like, you know, I wish you were able to catch at least Gen 2, maybe add in some Gen 2 or Gen 3 Pokemon to the mix, you know, that would be cool too. You know, Gen 1 Pokemon, in my opinion, is not all that exciting. I mean, yeah, you have the Indigo starters, like you have Bulbasaur, Charmander, and Squirtle. I wanted more. I mean, I don't care about Weezing or Arbok or any of those boring Pokemon. You know, it's like I want to experience new Pokemon. And I think at the time, people were really wanting a whole new Pokemon game instead of a remake. And I mean, you get what you get. You gotta be grateful that at least Nintendo at the time of 2018 was willing to release a sort of Pokemon game for the Switch, even though you probably would have thought that they would have did that at launch, or at least somewhere between fall or winter of 2017, during the year the Switch came out. I just wasn't satisfied with only having Gen 1 Pokemon. Another thing I didn't like about the game is, I guess you could kind of say, the difficulty. They didn't amp up the difficulty. They made it extremely easy. Like I mentioned previously in the video, that they were trying to target a younger audience. So when developers and companies are trying to target a younger audience as far as video game wise, they're going to want to make the game a little bit easier. But at the same time, with it being a remake, they kept a lot of originality, like the gym leaders and the Gen 1, to kind of keep that catering satisfactor to older Pokemon players such as myself. Now, I wasn't born when Red and Blue and all those came out on the Game Boy, you know, because I was like 94, 95, and I wasn't around then. You know, it's kind of nice that we still get some factors from Yellow, but at the same time, it's like super easy to kind of navigate your way through the game and beat it within a matter of like a few hours. You know, some people could easily sit there and beat that game in like 2 to 3 hours, but then you got people like me who was working 2 jobs at the time, got sick around the time playing the game, and couldn't really have a whole bunch of time to play it. Now, obviously, when I was sick, I had more time. I got close to beating it. I guess you could say another con that I didn't like about the game was that it felt too short. You know, the story wasn't, I don't want to say it wasn't as good, but it was, eh. You got to stop Team Rocket, and you know, you got the classic dumbasses, Jesse James and Meowth, the OG Team Rocket loser squad, whatever you want to call them. But I mean, the story was not that good. Like, you basically just have to stop Team Rocket from basically trying to take over the world, I guess. I don't know. The story was never really clear all that much. Personally, for me, for my taste, I didn't really like the story all that much. I just got the game because, you know, I'm a Pokemon fan and I love Pokemon. And it was like it was almost like what we were gonna get at the time as far as like a Pokemon game that you would play on like the DS or the 3DS. I took what I can get. I did like, although, the fact that you got to catch Zapdos, Articuno, and Moltres in various locations. Like, you got Seafoam Islands, got to get the Articuno, and then at the power plant you got Zapdos. I forgot where you catch Moltres, but I'll leave it here on the screen. And just experiencing those moments, catching those legendary Pokemon, that was actually really fun. Now, you still have a certain time limit on how long. I think you were given 4 minutes for each legendary Pokemon in order to battle it. And then once you basically tanked its HP, then you got to catch it. And then that was the same thing with Mewtwo after you beat the game. You get to go into another route of Mount Moon, and you get to catch Mewtwo. After you catch Mewtwo, if you were to go back in Mount Moon, you meet another trainer called Trainer Green. And, you know, in the game, there's Red. You battle Red after you beat the game. Then you battle Blue, I believe, after you beat the game. Or maybe you battle him twice. I forgot. But I remember you definitely battle him after you beat the game. Red was kind of easy to beat. Blue was fairly easy to beat. Green put up more of a challenge, but still was easy to beat. You know, and it was cool that you got to really get to experience, like, they had that little cutscene in the beginning for each one. Another con, I would say, that I didn't like was the Pokemon catching feature, where it was the same as Pokemon Go. I didn't like that setup where you felt like you were playing Pokemon Go when it came to catching Pokemon. I wasn't too huge on Pokemon Go. I was at first. Like, I went through like periods of liking Pokemon Go where it was like cool when it first came out, then I fell out, and then coworkers at work got me back into it, and then I fell out again, and I haven't played it in like maybe almost a year. But there are some people out there that are like really into Pokemon Go, and they're like religiously playing it every day and stuff, but I'm not one of those people. You know, I liked the gym leader, Brock, Misty, Lieutenant Sarge. I'm not gonna say them in order, or I might. Erica, what was after Erica? Koga, Sabrina, Blaine, Giovanni. Now, finding out Giovanni was a gym leader was kind of a surprise for me, because honestly, I didn't see that coming. I really didn't. Like, once you walk into that room and then you see it's Giovanni, you're like, oh crap, I gotta battle him again? And Giovanni is easy to beat, like, every single time. It's like nobody in that game was challenging. Now, except when you get to the Elite Four, But that's a different story, because Elite Four, some of them were a bit challenging, not all, but some of them did put up a fight. And I will say that was probably, honestly, not even really that challenging, but it was still kind of a tiny bit of a challenge. But the biggest surprise of all was when you're told you're not the champion at the end, somebody beat you to it, and you find out that it's your rival that you slash friend from the beginning of the game, and you find out it's him who was the champion, and you have to battle him for that spot. You know, it's like, it's crazy. I easily beat the rival in both Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee, and I became the champion. Another cool thing that you get to do at the end of the game, because there's so much you could do after beating the game, you can go back and re-battle the 8 gym leaders I previously named, and they don't have just like a few Pokemon. They have a lot more Pokemon on their team, and their levels are a lot higher, which makes more of a challenge when you re-battle them. And I will say it was kind of a bit of a challenge, and I kind of liked that. I liked that challenging factor, and it's the same thing when you go and battle the Elite Four again. You basically are introduced to newer Pokemon on their team and higher level Pokemon too at that as well. And I overall just liked the layout of the gyms. They looked really cool. You know, I liked the graphics in the game. The animation was really cool. If I were to rate this game a 1 out of 10, I'd give it about 6. You know, like I said, there were a lot of cons, but no matter how many cons there were in the game, I did enjoy it a lot when I played it. I did get it with the Pokeball Plus, and this was actually a gift from my girlfriend for Christmas back in 2018 when the game came out, because I didn't buy it right away. I didn't think Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee was worth $60, in my opinion. Now, obviously, it's a lot more if you were to get the Pokeball Plus with it. It's probably going to be roughly around maybe close to $100, but if you were to just get the game, it would round up for like a cheaper price, like $60. And I'm sure the game's price value is lower since the release. It's probably at $40 by now. I would say they probably should have just released it at $50, at like $49.99, because I wouldn't have paid $60 plus. I still wouldn't have paid that much for Let's Go Pikachu and Eevee. I did like how in the game there was Pokemon that would wander around in like the wild grass areas around the city and swimming in the ocean and stuff like that. I do really like that feel of actually getting to see Pokemon as you wander around and stuff like that. But at the same time, it did get annoying every time you were trying to run through and just try and speed rush through the game. You always stumbled and ran into a Pokemon and stuff like that. That was quite annoying. But like I said, it was always cool to see Pokemon wander. But alrighty guys, that's going to be it for the review. If you liked the video, leave a like. If you enjoy this channel, subscribe and hit the bell to get notified when I upload all videos. You can hit the personalized option to get notified when I upload every other video. Don't forget to check out my social media links in the description below. And don't forget to check out my Afrogeek channel. I've been putting out a lot of videos on there recently, so feel free to check that out. And I happen to talk about stuff like Pokemon over there too, and various other things involving movies and anime, etc. But alrighty guys, I am Pokemon 1086 and your boy is out of here.